Oh, hello, Apex Comics here. Guys, everyone, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, this is the process of how I collect or make my books. This is I've been printing out some preliminary copies, two of them, of Fembat, the entire 56 pages, plus a preliminary cover. This is what the preliminary cover will look like, but it's reduced to an ashcan size. This is 11 by 17, reduced 64% on a copier. Now you're going to have a 11 by 17 printed paper piece on this. It's going to look like this, but it's going to be some blank space on the bottom. Normally, if I were to print it up seriously, I would have a logo or the title of the book here and possibly my company logo behind here. But in this case, I'm printing up 56 pages for Double Flyer Rex. He'll be writing Fembat or Double Flyer versus Fembat, or Fembat versus Double Flyer, however you want to put the title on. But he needs resource material for my character. And I'm saying, well, you're one of two that will have this copy. One copy for me, one copy for Rex. So there you go. So in other words, I don't want to spoil anything for this book. I do want to sell this on fundmycomic.com once I get my mailing list figured out and my campaign. Then I'll be all rosy, hopefully. Anyway, the process. How do you put together a 56-page book? Well, I'm going to show you. Starting off, I've printed out some 11 by 17 on 8.5 by 11 sheets individually. These are like individual sheets for each page. And what I do is do a 56 page, well, it's 15 signatures. In other words, 15, that equals 60 pages, but 14 of them, 14 of these signatures are going to be inside pages, which is, you have 14 8.5 by 11 sheets, right? So this will be a signature for a 60-page book. In other words, you have 15 times 4. So there's one side, this side, this side. Four sides per sheet. That's what equals 4 pages. So this is the inside back cover, inside front cover. I'm sorry. Yeah. Yeah. It's sorry, this is the front cover. Sorry, front cover, back cover. Sorry about that. Then in the inside, you have an inside back cover and an inside, well, inside front cover and inside back cover. Yeah. Excuse me, I don't mean to confuse you. So this is the front cover here. We'll set this aside. And we have 1 and 56. All you do is you fold it. You fold these 14 sheets, 8.5 by 11 by 17, ends up being 5.5 by 8, correct? That's an ashcan size. So you have is 1, and what you do is you number each one as consecutively as you go on, 2 and 3, simply like that. And then you got 4 and 5, and it goes on. 6 and 7, you go all the way through. And your midpoint on 56 pages will be pages 28 and 29. This is your centerfold area, halfway. Then you go to like 30 and 31, all the way to 56 at the end of it. That's how you do it. It's very simple. Okay, so what I'm going to do, here's the end result of what it looks like. Beautiful, right? You have inside, this is the inside back cover. Apex Comics right here. Then you have, I'm not going to reveal the last page. This will be wrong. So this is 1 and then 56 is on the back. And your center point right here. Look how thick this baby is. It's a thick book. Okay, so we'll slide back into here. I'm going to attempt to staple it. This is the thickest ash can ever that I've produced. This is going to be, I think the book is going to be square bound because I want it to last. I want the customer to have a lasting book. We measured this out. This is a Bostitch staple I use Oh, let me put it this way. Box stitch, right? And so this is at 5.5 inches. Okay. So I normally do it the opposite way, but I'm going to do it this time on this way. And so we're going to center point. I think it may take a couple of staples just to be safe. Oh, good Lord. All right. 5.5 around midpoint. Because this, make sure this is all flush. I don't want anything sticking out. So I'm going to get a nice safe point. Make sure everything's unobstructed. I got to get rid of this large copier printer. It's not really doing me any good. I might have to send it off or recycle it somehow. I think what am I doing? Sorry. Let's do this correctly, shall we? Okay. Make sure it's all flushed up. Back it up a bit. Make sure you have plenty of space in your area. I'm jammed with some nonsense. I gotta clean this area. I need a bigger space, but you know what? Bigger spaces cost money, and we all know how that is. Alright, so I'm going to attempt to staple through. I'm going to keep the the messed up copy. I'm trying to give Rex the cleaner copy because he's paying for the processing and the shipping, of course. It's nice of him to do that. So, hey, if you haven't subscribed to Double Flyer Momentum channel, please do. It's our friend Rex. He has a book called Double Flyer. It's coming out. He has a Double Flyer Ashcan on Indiegogo, if you'd like to check that out. It's only $10. It's for, I think it's 24 pages, but it has a story in there, plus some first appearance of characters in his Momentum Comics universe. So if you would, check it out. Check out Indiegogo and Double Flyer. Double Flyer Ashcan. I'll be sure to put in the description of that after this video. So we're going to pinpoint it. Okay, make sure it's straight right here. Should have I would say 2/3 of the way to the top and about 2/3 of the way to the bottom. That's how normally the dadgum is so thick. That's what she said. All right, Lord have mercy. I hope this works out fine. Oh, so it tends to slide out a bit. You have to be very careful where you're stapling here. Make sure it's not going to go out on me. All right. Here we go. Ooh, it seems to work. Wow. Okay. Here you go. We'll do another one. Another staple here. Midpoint. I'd say what's 2/3 of a point? So we've got midpoint here. We're going to staple it. I'd say pretty close to right here. Don't get secure. Yeah, all right. Yeah, it looks pretty good. It's solid. It's a nice, it's a little bent. I'm going to keep this one. Give Rex a better copy of this. So this is the 56-page Ashcan version of Fembat, but I want to show you the process of adding some gutters. Very important to add some gutters to your mid-center section, so that way it's easier to print off, to copy off. See? Looks really nice. Don't want to give a lot away. So I may have to put a little, I'll put a tile on here and just probably just glue it or something. To say it's Fembat. Oh, I cannot mistake it. Okay, at least inside has to copy my bookmark. Oosh. I don't want to reveal the page. Ooh, okay. Easy. Dargone it. All right. I'm sure you probably didn't see much of that anyway. Yeah, give me a good like and subscribe and ring bell for notifications. So your center point's very important when you print out each page. But at the same time, once you get it printed, you gotta have to correlate them together. Once the pages are correlated together, this is gonna have to be trimmed out, which I did. I paid the extra $6.50 for that. So yeah, trim it out, and once it's trimmed out, you're gonna have a book that's pretty tight, like this. You know, everything's all trimmed. There you have it. Femme Bat Baby. She looking good, baby. Do the honors, if you would. Share this video. This is how to produce my 56-page ashcan of Femme Bat. This is a preliminary copy. You know what to do. Like, subscribe, ring bell for notifications, share the video. Until next time, ciao for now.